This time of year, you could tell that something's a bit different at Fairview High School.
It's really chaotic. Like, the energy is so different in the last few days of school. Like, everyone's, like, really excited.
While the dreaded finals are looming, the promise of summer break and graduation can be felt in the hallways and in the classrooms.
Oh, it's the last week of school.
3 days.
It's the last time I'm gonna see a lot of these people.
Yeah, the yearbooks are coming out, and the energy is just a lot more relaxed.
Big exams coming up, and they're just trying to hold it all together. It's a little bit of organized chaos.
This level of excitement is comparable to what was experienced in the hallways a couple years ago when a student, Kyle Fridberg, made a rare discovery.
It's incredibly rare.
While cycling near Gold Hill in Boulder County, a rock caught his attention.
I observed kind of an interesting looking rock. I didn't think it was anything too special, but having an interest in geology, I decided to just take a sample back to my garage lab just to see what it was.
He really kind of burst into my office unannounced, and he said, "Dr. Strode, I think I've discovered something." I think the word is serendipity. He was in the right place at the right time. He looked in the right direction at the right moment. But anyone else wouldn't have noticed anything. He just happened to be the right person.
The right person with a lot of curiosity.
Where I found the rock was definitely cool, but this right here, this is the discovery. When I placed it in sulfuric acid, I ended up getting this really deep red solution. This is super uncharacteristic of how rocks typically react with sulfuric acid. And so, yeah, I looked into the literature, I tried to find some kind of reference to this reaction, and I couldn't find any. That was what led me to go on nearly a year-long journey to try to identify this compound.
A lot of the time, and especially at Kyle's age, you get something funny and you just, like, well, I don't understand it, and then you're done. But what makes Kyle unique is that he saw something funny and he followed it. He chased it.
Eventually, with the help of a University of Colorado professor, Kyle was able to figure out exactly what he had found.
The compound I discovered is called hydrogen ferric manganic sulfate. So it's a bit of a mouthful. I just abbreviate it to HFMS. Just a pretty basic metal sulfate compound.
A basic compound that could be helpful in improving rechargeable battery technology made him the world champion in chemistry at the International Science and Engineering Fair.
The sixth place winner.
And earned him $80,000 at this year's Regeneron Science Talent Search.
To watch him on their live feed on Facebook get, you know, sixth place was just mind-blowing. So proud.
For Kyle, the reward was really finding the answer to his curiosity.
One time somebody asked him, like, how did it feel like standing up on that stage? And he said, you know, I honestly felt more excited when I discovered what the compound had been made out of.
Kyle's friends say that's just the way he is.
His curiosity is really contagious, really. It makes me want to go out and explore.
And now if I add the solution to the silver metal, one of the things that drives me is my curiosity. Curiosity is really a great resource for learning because it is so accessible to everyone.
That's why a lot of teachers in the Boulder Valley School District are looking for ways to keep curiosity and joy of learning alive and growing through hands-on experiential learning.
Just doing rote memorization or just worksheets to try to memorize things is useful for very basic concepts.
The oxidation of the silver.
But then when concepts start becoming more complex, it's useful to have a more hands-on system.
Our hope is that this approach will create even more explorers, like Kyle, fueling discoveries that could one day solve the world's biggest challenges.